Hi, Sharks. I'm Mark Singer.
And I'm Kenza Singer. We're a father and son duo from Santa Barbara and are here to ask for $25,000 for a 5% stake in our company, Iris. Sharks, I have a question for you. What do sugarless ice cream, low-salt turkey bacon, and cheese-free mac and cheese all have in common?
They were all bought by mistake because I didn't have my reading glasses with me at the supermarket.
Yeah. And we had to eat all that stuff.
That's
People
great.
Like my parents who need reading glasses know the frustration of not having their readers with them when they need them. But it doesn't always have to be like that.
Actually, I'm wearing my reading glasses right now. With one hand, in one motion, and in 1 second, Iris reading glasses change from wrist wear.
Oh my
God.
There you go.
And back again.
That's pretty cool.
Wow. That is cool. Dad, why don't you show them one more time? Using our patented memory metal bridge design, Iris reading glasses both spring open and snap shut.
How clever is
Amazing.
That?
Today, Iris has received 4 international design awards.
But more importantly, Iris reading glasses are fashionable.
So which of you is interested in forming a strategic partnership
to share our vision
and allow the world to see the power of Iris? Huh. Sharks, in front of you are samples for you to try
Best
out for yourselves.
Best pitch ever.
Thank you.
You know, it's really clever. Now, I have a very small wrist, and it fits. Are there different sizes?
Oh, it's only got little baby stems.
All one size?
We're starting out with a universal one-size-fits-all. So it should fit most everyone, about 95% of the population is what we were going for.
And you have a patent on this. So I see right there, it looks like a utility patent.
That's correct. We have a utility patent in the United States, China, Japan, and soon to issue in 26 European countries.
These grippers, do they leave a mark in your skin if you're wearing these for like an hour?
It's a great question.
I've been wearing them sometimes 24/7 for months. And they may leave a little bit, but nothing that has been bothersome.
The reading glasses, they're not long-term, you know,
they're meant
your
for
head.
On the go.
That's exactly right. These are designed for the dozens and dozens of times a day that you need to take them off, put them on, check your phone, one hand, one motion, 1 second.
And what do you sell them for? What do they cost you to make?
Yeah.
So they cost us $30.50. That's landed in our warehouse, ready to go. We sell them for $110 online, and that includes free shipping.
Are you an inventor?
Yeah, for me, it was need-based product. As I got older, I needed reading glasses more and more, and they were never with me when I needed them. I thought the solution was to buy a dozen pair and put them everywhere. I still didn't have them when I needed them. Fortunately, my son had an eye on me, and he came up with the...
Are you an engineer?
I am, yes, I have a bachelor's and a master's degree in structural engineering from Cornell University.
How did you come up with the idea? How did you figure it out?
I was working as a structural engineer, and I designed everything from skyscrapers to soccer stadiums and thought that, you know, hey, physics at the scale of a skyscraper also applies to something as small as a pair of reading glasses. So I just kind of applied what I knew to come up with this mechanism that's both stable open and stable closed. We spent a weekend in his wood shop prototyping it, figured it out, and once we got a working prototype, we thought, hey, this could work, and that's when I quit my engineering job and did this full time.
Mark, wow. What was your reaction when your son outwit you?
If you think starting a business is tough, try doing it with your kid.
Try doing it with your dad. Oh, my God.
We just didn't hear Mark's background. What's your background?
Well, I left home at about 15 and a half. I barely graduated high school, never got out of college. I'm mostly a woodworker. For over 60 years, I've been designing and making furniture. Although along the way, I have started some companies and brought a number of products to market, including one you might actually be aware of.
Which one was that?
Gorilla Glue.
The what? Oh,
wow. Gorilla glue.
That's
You're
yours?
You're kidding.
Yeah.
I have a bottle of that back at the hotel right now.
That's what he pastes his hairpiece with.
And you sold that? That's a massive company now.
Yes, I did sell that years ago.
Excellent. Wow.
Was that a good outcome for you?
Every company that I've ever sold has included a royalty component, so yes. it's worked out very well.
Did you say royalty?
I did, sir.
Outstanding.
Good man.